We're going to talk today about healing a rejected mother, wounds of a rejected mother. Last week we talked a little bit about the women that I thought were the five greatest mothers in the Bible. And we talked through what made them great. Essentially, there were three things that made the women great mothers. Are you ready to remember those? Maybe you should write some of them down. One, they created or raised up children who were whole emotionally. They had a sense of well-being and self-confidence. All right? Number two, they had a sense of destiny. And I think you can have a sense of well-being without necessarily having a sense of destiny. Third, they had a capacity to come into a genuine relationship with their God. Now, according to Jewish tradition, you will understand that the first 5 years of life are really under the mother's tutelage. And from 5 years on, historically, the dad's job would be to lead the process of raising up and discipling a child, including bringing that kid into the family business. And he would give that kid essentially five things: a sense of affirmation, approval. There would be acceptance. There would be affection that fathers give. And there should be a sense of authority. Authority is the fact that there would be consequences for their actions. And so we find that in many, many homes, moms do their job and give those kids a sense of internal wholeness, a sense of destiny, and a capacity to ultimately meet with God and be born again and transformed. But because fathers are absent in the process, we find that the kids are never fully formed in terms of the moral dynamics of their life, and therefore you have gifted people who can't hear anybody. There's no sense of concrete authority in their lives. They are talked to by a coach, and they want to choke the coach. And all of that comes out of the lack of a father either knowing what the dynamics are and those five dimensions of input that the father is supposed to put into the life of the child.
Are you ready to break through to your destiny? International Communion of Evangelical Churches presents You Were Born for More, Kingdom Protocol. Come and join us on Wednesday 12th to Saturday 15th of June 2013 at Hope Christian Church, 6251 Amindale Road, Beltsville, Maryland, featuring host pastor Bishop Harry Jackson.
See, in these moments of total makeover, God is trying to do something in your life, and he's working in levels and waves of grace that if you'll embrace the way he wants to work in your life, he'll take you from point A to point B, and you'll be transformed, and you'll be like a sharpened instrument in his hand.
Bishop Bill Hammond.
Don't judge your future based on your past. What you couldn't do yesterday, you'll be able to do tomorrow. Hallelujah. There's new grace. There's new power. There's new authority. There's new anointing.
Dr. Mark Chirona.
I'm feeding on my papa's word of affirmation. And until he says something else, that food will get me through this hallway.
You'll also hear from other anointed and gifted powerhouse speakers, Dr. Sharon Nesbitt, Pastor Jerome Liberty of South Africa, Dr. Patricia Bailey-Jones, Johnny Enloe, Bishop Joseph Matera, and Pastor Doug Morin. Soul-stirring music by Psalmist Elder Eugene Brown. For more information or to register, call 240-845-0388 or visit our website at www.icechurches.org. You were born for more. Kingdom Protocol. 3 days of gospel music and the Word of God.